My name is John Antle, and I'm a professor of applied economics at Oregon State University. I like to start talking about climate change by emphasizing that it's about science, not about belief. Most people start the conversation asking, do you believe in climate change? And I think that's actually the wrong question. It's not a question of belief in climate change, but it's about the science and the facts. And we have irrefutable data that show that humans are causing climate change. The rapid increase in greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, and we know that the greenhouse effect is real. So the laws of physics tell us that the Earth system is going to change. Once we acknowledge that fact, then we can have a useful discussion about climate change. My research is about answering the question how we achieve more sustainable development pathways. Our economy is on a trajectory over time. And how do we make that more sustainable, and what do we mean by sustainability? Like I was saying, climate change is a big part of sustainable development, but it's not the only part. And most of my work brings that down to the level of agriculture and farming systems and asks how can we get systems to perform better in three dimensions that we used to think about sustainability: economic, environmental, and social. Our current economic system rewards people to do certain things, typically to produce things that are bought and sold in markets. So for example, farmers who use systems that emit less greenhouse gases actually find that they're probably less profitable than if they use practices that emitted more greenhouse gases. So wider society benefits, but farmers would have to pay a cost. And so the key question becomes, who really is willing to pay for sustainability and for dealing with climate change? How do we create incentives for people to really change their behavior in ways that lead to more sustainable outcomes? One of the big challenges then is to understand how we can take agriculture and link that to food systems, and then of course to all the other elements of the economy. What we see is the role of science really then is to create ways to provide that kind of evidence, good science, solid sound science evidence to people so they can understand the options that we have. What we economists would say is it's going to take effort on the demand side and on the supply side. The farmers producing crops are on the supply side. Sure, they can produce crops more sustainably, but it really helps to have that pull from the demand side. If people want to buy food that's more sustainably produced, that sends a market signal through to the farmers. So it's really important both to have that desire among the population, you know, all of us, consumers, voters, to encourage the government, to encourage the private sector to do all these things that help the whole system move in a more sustainable direction. Because we know now that we really have to make big changes. And to make big changes, we're all going to have to agree that we need to do it. In the science community now say, we still have some time, but we really have to start to get serious about changing our energy system, the way we produce and consume food. Those are two of the big factors we know that are really going to make a difference.